The toy playground epidemic. The simplest model, there are 100 kids on a green playground. Blue kids are healthy. Red kids are sick. There's one initial red kid. When a red kid bumps into a blue kid, he gives him the disease with some probability. And then after you're red for a while, you're removed from play. Oh, that's it. I guess in that run, one kid. But he's going to die too. I just stopped the movie at that point. Agent-based models are artificial societies of software people. The people interact with each other, and those interactions generate social phenomena, health phenomena that we care about. Epidemics, distributions of wealth, distributions in the burden of disease, spatial patterns, norms of health behavior, patterns of addiction, and so forth. The idea is that we build these agent-based models, equip them with human-like decision systems, and see if their interactions can generate the phenomenon from the bottom up. It explains these phenomena and sometimes suggests very interesting bottom-up solutions. It's sort of Sim City, but much, much more serious. We're interested in calibrating these models to real-world data. So when you build a model of smallpox or pandemic flu, it has some empirical credibility, which increases its impact. There are individual-based models in economics. They assume a perfectly informed, rational, optimizing actor. This is simply not the way humans make their decisions, and we've tried to develop a next-generation agent that has emotions, social networks, bounded rationality. One piece of Agent Zero is a very simple toy model of fear. Then, like humans, they have imperfect data, they analyze it incorrectly, and they make a poor statistical inference. But they're also in a network of other emotionally driven and partially rational creatures. And when you put them all together, they produce genocide, dysfunctional health behaviors, all sorts of collective dynamics that are very disturbing that a rational collective would not do. And we're trying to use it to study addiction, smoking, alcoholism, all kinds of phenomena in which rational behavior can be overridden. Agent-based modeling is the all-terrain vehicle. You can use it to study all of these. It's had a huge impact in the way we do infectious disease modeling and infectious disease policy design. Stakeholders are really part of the modeling team. And then when it produces a counterintuitive result, they're not scared away from it.